Namaskaram. I had the privilege of knowing Kalki Mama right from my childhood days. My father, Surya Narayanan, known as Suri, was the auditor for Kalki magazine and also for the Kalki family members. So I have had the many opportunities to be with M.S. Mami, Sadasiva Mama, Radha, Anandi, Vijaya, and Kalki Mama, Rukmani Mami. In all occasions, in all any special occasion in their house or my house, there used to be a get-together, and I've always watched him as a young girl. If Mahakavi Bharati is credited with the fact that he is the one who simplified the grammatical Tamil, the Pandita Tamil, the Sen Tamil, simplified it and took it to the commoner to enjoy literature. I strongly believe, I'm sure many like me also believes, that it is Kalki Mama, Kalki Krishnamurti, the great legend, the writer, who made every woman in an household, women who were confined to the kitchen, to go in search of magazines and good literature and stories. He made them read. Women started reading only after Kalki Mama's stories started appearing in magazines. This is a fact. Nobody can deny this. For this, I can give you an example. My own grandmother, father's mother, she was 90 years old. I must have been 7 or 8, 9 years. She was bedridden, and she would ask any one family member to read every week Kalki's chapters, which had Ponniyin Selvan in that. Ponniyin Selvan's chapters. She was so addicted to it, and she would always wait for the magazine to arrive. First thing is, she should be the first person to have read the story. In other words, because nobody else can read it. Party has to read it first. Though she cannot read, somebody has to read it for her, but it was her first choice. And many times I have seen that after the chapter reading is over, she would just clasp her hands like this and pray, sort of aloud, "God, please give me life and so long as Ponniyin Selvan is running." I mean, she said, "Don't take away my life before Ponniyin Selvan ends. I want to see the end of Ponniyin Selvan." That was her desire. If a 90-year-old bedridden woman can feel like that, we can understand the power of Kalki Mama's writing, the way it sort of attracted and made people enjoy literature through simple writing and descriptions. I had never realized in my childhood days that Kalki Mama is a legend and a great writer. I knew he was an important writer, but all his salient features and greatness I came to know only later, after my teens, when I started reading his works, and much more after becoming a writer. So for me, I at the age of 8 and 9, I never had any interest to read serials or stories or book. Probably maximum I would read was comics. But when everybody has read that week's that issue of Kalki, I will take it quietly and go to my desk, take out my crayons, open up the Ponniyin Selvan page and start coloring Maniyam's illustrations, the huge illustrations. Nandini with big eyes and the fancy hairdo, Vandiyathevan, Alvar Kadiyan, Poongurali, her attire and her headdress. Everything fascinated me, and I by coloring them, I thought I'm bringing life into them. It was such an enjoyable thing for me, not just fun. I enjoyed it. And I still remember once when Appa was visiting Kalki Mama in Gandhinagar house, I went with him, took a couple of these Kalki issues with me. And when I was near Mama and he was inquiring about my well-being and everything, my studies or whatever it is, I said, "Mama, I want to show you something." He said, "Enama, what?" Then I opened the Kalki, these pages, colored pages, and showed it to him with great pride. And Mama sincerely looked at them and enjoyed it. He said, "Besh, besh, pramado." You know, that was a big, big compliment for me. And I remember the tone and his eyes, the way he was concerned and happy. Rukmini Mami, after Mama passed away, when I had established myself as a writer, whenever I went to Sri Rajendran's house to see Vijaya and Rajendran, Mami used to be there. She'll hold my hand tightly and she would talk about, literally give me a review about the recent story I'd written, how she enjoyed it, what is it that she liked in that. And on top of it, she never failed to say, "If Mama is here, he would have been very, very happy to see you blossoming into a writer." I mean, true, very true. When I realized the greatness of Mama, Kalki Mama, I could not interact with him, nor when I became a writer, I could not get him read my works and get his comments and reviews and blessings. I remember one incident very clearly that happened when I was probably 10 years old. Some of you might have heard of Annadana Sivan, a person who lived in and around Kumbakonam, and he would make enormous preparations to feed people who come for Mahamagam or Tulasnanam or some other festival in and around Kumbakonam. He was not a well-to-do person, but he would collect, work meticulously and feed thousands and lakhs of people. So his original name vanished and he was known as Annadana Sivan. After his passing away, a few years afterwards, my father and some of his friends heard about him and they wanted to continue the good work. And whenever there was a festival or function happening in Kumbakonam, this group will go from Madras and do the preparations and feed people, few thousands or whoever, people who come there. Once, I distinctly remember that for some festival, I don't remember what festival it is, for some festival, there was Annadhanam in the morning. And in the evening, there was a public function, meeting. And to speak in that public meeting, the then Chief Minister, Mr. Bhaktavatsalam, and Kalki Mama and few others had come from Madras to Kumbakonam. Morning, the Annadhanam thing was over. And while they were all having lunch, I was just running here and there as a young girl, playing with my age group children. Kalki Mama suddenly called me, "Hey, come here." So I went near him and I stood and he said, "Do you know who this Annadana Sivan is?" I said, "Yes, Mama, I know." "What do you know?" I said, "I know his original name is Ramaswamy. He was born in Teppermalnallur. And he is feeding thousands and lakhs of people, which is a great charity work, and he's a great philanthropist." Mama said, "Oh, you seem to know so much. I'll tell you what. This evening, before all of us speak, I want you to get onto the stage and speak for at least 5 to 7 minutes. My father, everybody looked at me and I just nodded. I said, "Okay, Mama." So, and that evening I got onto the stage when all these dignitaries were sitting behind me. And I still have the picture. thin me, about 10 years, standing in front of a mic with a huge badge of Annadhana Sivan badge pinned on my blouse, Pavada Shatta, and Mama and CM, everybody sitting in a row behind. I spoke because I never had any stage fear. And once I finished, there was a huge applause, and the person to lead the whole thing was Kalki Mama. Kalki Mama was so happy, he hugged me, and he sort of blessed me in Annar, you know. And in the year 1999, Mama's centenary year, the family decided to celebrate it in his birthplace, Puttamangalam. So when all of them went, I was also invited. I joined them, and a group of 20 people or more, we went from here to Mayavaram, from Mayavaram to his birthplace. It was a beautiful, beautiful experience. It's a green, lovely village, and the house was the house where Mama was born. It's a typical village house with a slanting roof, with tiled roof, and you have to bend a little to get inside, and the moment you enter, the courtyard is there. And in the courtyard, all the family members and all of us, about 20, 25 of us, some locals also, stood. And we sang Kaatrinile Varum Geetha, the most popular song in the movie Meera, sung by Emma Samma. This is penned by Kalki Mama. So as a tribute and a homage, we all sang. And you know, there was no practice, nothing, but in that serene atmosphere, even the locals joining us, it was a chorus. It was so beautiful, so touching. And we could feel the vibration there. That was one of the best experiences I've had. My first speech was started by Kalki Mama at the age of 10. Similarly, Kalki magazine published the first ever short story, Avargal Pesattum, in Kalki magazine. So I have as a human being and as a writer, I have long years of bonding with Kalki and Kalki family. And I'm so happy that even today, that bondage, that affection continues between all of us. And it's a pleasure, privilege and honor to have known Kalki Mama, MS Mami, Sadasiva Mama and all the great giants in literary and music field. And I feel truly blessed to have been associated with all these great people. Thank you.